Hi guys, welcome back to another video. This is Kyle Broflowski, ex-female listener. I will link the story in the description below. So, enjoy.
Hi, my name is Kyle Broflowski. I am 14 years old. I live in South Park with my friends Stan and Kenny. Cartman, I guess, really isn't a friend, but somehow there. I guess I was a happy boy before a girl came into my path. That's right, a girl. Her name is Wyan. She is very gorgeous, the most wonderful girl to stumble into my arms. But that was 2 months ago. Wyan, she happens to be missing. She disappeared one day, at least 2 days ago. I've been searching for her all day and night, not giving up. So I'll be telling you everything that happened before she disappeared. It started on a Wednesday. I went to second period like usual, but the teacher came in and said, "Okay, students, today we have a new student. Her name is Wyan," she says. But I looked down, just reading the title of my book. "So Wyan, tell us about yourself," the teacher asked her. As I look up, "Well, you know, my name is Wyan. I love to draw. I like to sing a little. I like to act. And I'm very nervous, but you can't really tell," she explains. I look at her details. Her hair was so pretty. Her face had such a beautiful detail, and her eyes sparkled like... But I look at her details. Her hair was so pretty. Her face had such a beautiful detail, and her eyes sparkled like the ocean. As I felt my face heat up, then my throat got dry, as the teacher calls my name. Kyle, raise your hand so Wyan knows where to sit," they say. So my hand shoots up. "Hey Kyle, I'm Wyan," she says, sitting in the desk beside me. "Hey," I say, looking at her. "Want to be my first friend here?" she asks. "Sure, I guess another isn't so bad," I say, as she laughs a little. She holds her hand out as we shake hands. "So where are you from?" I ask. "I moved from whatever, but I guess it doesn't matter," she says. "Oh wow," I say. "So how long have you lived here?" she asks. "I guess my whole life," I say. She looks a little shocked. "What, like 13 years?" she asks. "Well, 14, I say. 14? She whispers, yells, and then covers her mouth. I smile a little, seeing her shocked expression made her so cute. "Hey, want to sit with me at lunch?" I ask. "Yeah, okay," she says, smiling. "Great," I say. We had spent the whole rest of class talking instead of learning. Then the bell rang. "Hey, do I have any other hours with you?" she asked, holding a paper. "Here, let's see. You have math, which is done, science, gym, and history with me," I say, and she nods. "Okay then, bye," she says. "Bye," I say, waving bye. "Hey Kyle," stands, says, as he puts his arm around my shoulder. "Hey dude," I say. "Who's that?" he asks, pointing at Wyan. "That's Wyan, she's not here," I say. "Oh, I guess I'll go say hi," he says, and walks over. I just shrugged and went to my next class. At lunch, "Kyle," I heard my name be called as I turned around to see Wyan jogging to me. "Hey," I say. "So, where do you sit?" she asks. "With these guys," as I say as we walk to my table. "Guys, meet Wyan. Wyan, meet Kenny, Stan, and Cartman," I say. "Hey," they all said hi. "So you're new," Kenny asks, looking up at her and down. "Yes, I am, but I wouldn't try anything," she says. Mostly Cartman stayed quiet. I didn't really know why, but I didn't care. "I can't believe you came 2 months before school ends," Stan says.
"My mama is the one who wanted to marry someone," she says. "If you're wondering, my dad isn't dead. He's off with some other woman," she says. "Oh," we all said. "So have you met your new stepdad then?" I ask. "Yeah, he's pretty nice. Dad's like my real dad," she says. But she starts to change the subject. "And if you're wondering, no, her dad wasn't gross. He just always gave her chores and thought she had to be a hard worker." "So what do you guys like?" she asks. "Kenny being Kenny, women," he says. "Interesting," she says. "Stan, what do you like?" she asks. "Hanging out with my best friends and Wendy," Stan says. "Wendy?" she asks. "That's my girlfriend," he says. Is it that one?" she asks, pointing to Wendy. "Actually, yes," I say. "Isn't she pretty?" Stan says, staring at her. "I guess so," Wyan says. "So Kyle, what do you like?" she asks, looking into my eyes. "I like sports, mostly basketball. I'm into music, I guess," I say. "I used to play basketball. Wasn't really my sport," she says, smiling. "Well, we're not always good at everything," I say. "Hey, should we all hang out after
after school, Kenny asks.
Yeah, sure,
means Stan say. I guess, Carmen says. What about you, Wyan? I ask.
I guess I'll tag along, she says.
Great, I say. After lunch, the school day went on like usually, but this time Wyan was here.
So when the school day ended, I waited at the front like usual waiting for them.
As they started to come, I see Wendy and Bebe chatting with Wyan, probably trying to get her to join cheerleading.
Yeah, that's cool, Wendy, but cheerleading isn't my calling, so I hung up a long time ago, Wyan says.
Aw, if you insist, Wendy says. Puppy dog eyes.
Okay, bye, Wyan says.
Okay then, bye, Wyan, Bebe says as Wendy follows her. Why don't you join cheerleading, Kenny asks.
Well, I got no reason to join, so why do it, she says.
Plus, I'm not really meant for the spotlight, she says.
It's really cold here, Wyan says.
I guess I'm not used to the weather here, I say.
Nope, the weather back home is much different.
Like how different, Kenny asks. Then she explains to him how different her town is.
Kenny did look amazed, but that's just Kenny.
Stan did listen to most of it. Carmen didn't listen at all.
Why listen to every word she said?
I knew I was blind at the time to even realize I love her, but that doesn't happen for at least a few days later. And this is just one day.
Hello, loves.
Oh my gosh, this took like 2 days to finish. It was supposed to be released yesterday and the day before, but I guess I was so busy reading this. Oh my gosh. I'm so sorry for the delay. I've been pretty busy. And I'll try to be, like I said in my other video, I'll try to be more active as I can while doing this. But I will be taking a little break. Because I have to study because I have school, and my start test is coming up, and I have to pack because I'm heading home. I'm heading back home for a while to visit my family, and I'll see once I get there. When I land there, I'll try to make more audios. But I hope you guys enjoy the story, and I'll see you guys in another video. Later. Stay sweet. Bye.